I want to know, what can I do right away to prevent scarring or to heal faster? Because they don't want to keep Band-Aids on. They don't want to keep their hands out of the way. And as you can see, there's the photo. It breaks my heart. But Avery got a scratch.
I saw it early on. I am going to take this question because this relates to wound healing in general, and what applies to kids applies to adults. And Jim, kids, the great thing about kids, they heal great. Mm-hmm. They really do. Their healing response is so good. Initially, cuts may be a little bit red, but in time, the redness may last a little longer in a child. When it fades, like in Avery's case, because now I barely can see that scar, and it will disappear. But in a nutshell, it's just a normal healing process that we see in the skin, and this represents a scab. I know it's tough with kids, but you want to have the kids leave the scab in place because it acts as a physiologic Band-Aid. I know it's tough. You want to keep them from picking and pulling. Maybe Jim has a trick for that. But in general, the things you want to do, protect it from the sun, sunscreen, wear a hat, zinc oxide. Zinc helps to heal wounds, but it'll also protect from the sun. Fat-soluble vitamins, A, D, E, K, are all good. Add a little vitamin C, too. And the over-the-counter preparations that have gel in it, silicone gel, are all great to help.
So those are safe for babies?
They're all safe for babies. What applies for adults applies for babies.
Jacqueline, I know you have a question about Chanel.
Chanel is generally a great baby, but she started this phase where she's likes to break things or hit me or bite me, but she doesn't really do it to anybody else. Why does she do that to me?
Uh-huh. Wow, yeah, my kids are like that too, you know, and it's something about the parent. You know, kids, when they're younger, they tend to just not want to obey their parents. You know, I think it's because they feel so much more comfortable with you. It's actually kind of a good sign that, you know, she's like comfortable to disobey you. It's kind of her starting to express her own will. And one of the tricks I did, you never want to bite back, but if you see her teeth going for your arm, I would kind of put her arm in the way. Okay. So she accidentally gets her own arm, and then she'll go, oh, that kind of hurts. You know, and then they'll start to get it.
Okay. Yeah, I love that. Thank you.
Nicole, you're up.
Well, Charlie has been entering the stage of night terrors. Ooh. I believe that's what it's called. Mm-hmm. Like, she'll get up multiple times during the night and
kind of like she's having a bad dream.
And she's having the most terrifying nightmare of her life, and she'll kick and scream like bloody murder, and it can go on for like 45 minutes, and her eyes are open. So I'm like, when it first happened, I'm like, I don't know what's wrong with her. I've never seen anything like that.
Yeah,
I almost started crying because she looked so stressed out and scared. And I'm like, what am I doing wrong?
Yeah, this really sounds like a night terror, but there's a kind of a quick trick I can have you do. For a couple of nights, or if you can just remember, if there's a certain time it tends to start, okay, we want to track, okay, if these are, they're kind of predictable within an hour or two of when they're going to happen in each night. And then once you kind of have a good starting time logged, then you're going to actually wake her up about 15 to 30 minutes before it's expected to happen.
Oh, really?
All right?
Okay.
And you just have her up for about 5 minutes, maybe a quick feeding or something, she'll go back to sleep. And if you do that for 7 nights in a row, it usually breaks the cycle.
Okay.
And that will fix 90% of night terrors. Oh, we got Daddy. Daddy coming.
There's Daddy.
There's Daddy.
There's Dad.
That'll work.
Daddy. Our executive producer, Jay McGraw, happens to be Erica's husband and Avery's father.
Yeah. Daddy.
Ooh, look at you.
Now she's happy.
Now she's happy.
Okay, that works.
So I have one more question about sleeping. When do we transition to a big girl bed?
Probably the biggest thing is if a toddler is starting to climb out over the crib, that can be dangerous because they're good at climbing up. They're not good at climbing down, and they will just fall right over. So I want to show you something over here, okay?
Okay.
We're going to go see a new bed?
There.
Look at this.
Look at this. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh, I want that bed.
Right, so this is the KidCraft Princess toddler bed, and this is kind of cool. It's basically like a little cot, and the key, it's low to the ground, okay? So, because she's going to start getting up, and that way, even if she falls out of it, it's not that far, okay? Yeah. And it's cool, because it uses your crib mattress, all right? So she's already used to sleeping on this mattress. This is going to be her mattress, you know, from her crib. You just put it in this new in this new toddler bed. Pretty cool, huh?